ties. Every nigga that bitch that try to stop me. Just a young nigga trying to make Skrilla. Learn to double it up with the killers and the drug dealers. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. It's hard times on the blocks and the projects. Call my girl up, it's time to flip my kind of check. I got cocaine, weed, and it better me. Pop said, P, keep your eyes on your enemy. I ain't trusting no nigga or no bitch. That's the recipe in the hood, nigga, to getting rich. Thugs, keep a gas right beside them. True niggas keep my gas, cause we riders. Hold the gauge, motherfucker, why I blow his head? Hit the horn, motherfucker, two niggas dead. R.I.P. Fucking enemy. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. In school, it's pencils and pads and books. In the ghetto, it's texts and killers and crooks. I done seen blood shed over blood money. I done seen niggas kill over drug money. Got the game from some OG ballin'. Down here, third wall, Kelly, yo, New Orleans. They bury me a paid nigga. I won't change cause the P is a made nigga. I got killers and dealers on my side. I got homies and jackals ready to ride. Got the game in my bang cause I'm about this. How many niggas out there really doubt this? If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders.
Camouflage and all that. Murder, murder, kill, killer shit. Bad nigga from the bricks. Blood on my kicks. Seen it all in the project halls and the street corners. And never choked even when them folks ran up on us. Soldier rag tag on my eye. No lie. Fuck with me for sure die. No lie. I'm making niggas follow my lead. Envious to swallow my feet. Laying niggas down like nigga. Apollo Creed need. Got my game from that nigga versus. Keep the enemies close. Shoot verses, show the fakes, no mercy. Never dance with them youngsters. In your life, nigga, you don't wanna live amongst us. We ain't right, I was born in it. Y'all niggas was sworn in it. Fuck around and get your whole clique tormented. Bulletproof vest, cover my chest, so you nigga. Best aim for my brain if you're trying to put me to rest.
If you want me, come get me. How the fuck you gon' take me? I got my true niggas with me and we riders. If you want me, come
Blaq Hippie Radio Entertainment live and direct show. That was Master P and we riders. Hey, that Ghetto D album was a classic, man.
I thought it was funny.
Did you like it?
It had its moments, but it was funny, man.
It's a classic album, man. Don't do P like that.
Don't though. Do P. Hey, man, he'll be the first to admit to you that he wasn't a real artist, man.
He wasn't, but you know the production of it was decent.
Oh, Beats by the Pound, definitely. Yeah. They had talent, you know.
Where the fuck they at, man? What happened to them?
I don't know. They need to get back out there, man.
Because I know they had switched their names when they left the...
No, they switched their names to?
Medicine Men.
Medicine Men?
Yeah, and they had produced my man's Mystical album. After he got off of No Limit. And then I ain't hear nothing from him after that. Mm. I don't know. The Master P just blackballed him. Like, man, if you ain't with me, you ain't doing nothing.
I don't know. We got to figure that story out. But, man, Joe, tonight we got NFL football. Yeah, NFL back.
Hall of Fame game.
Got the Hall of Fame game. Got the Cowboys versus the Cardinals tonight. Coming on, you know. What channel they on? I don't even know what the fuck channel they on.
It should be on Fox.
It's going to come on national?
Yeah, it should be on Fox. If it ain't on Fox, it'll be ABC. I mean, not ABC.
Well,
ABC
is NBC. Yeah, it's going to be on NBC. They got Al Michaels and Chris Collinsworth. They calling the game tonight.
Damn, they get all the spotlight games, don't they?
I actually like Chris Collinsworth, man. A lot of people don't like him.
He's cool with me. I don't like that motherfucking Boomer Esiason, man.
I like Boomer. Boomer, he got his moments.
Okay,
man.
You know what? Shoot me, because I was thinking about that other idiot, Phil Sims. That's who I don't like.
Now, Phil Sims? Yeah, goofball.
Yeah, throw his ass in a well somewhere.
But yeah, with this whole football thing, you know, kicking off, you know, make sure y'all check out the Hall of Fame game. I know I'll be tuning in tonight. But we got the whole Colin K. He's still not, you know, he's still not signed. And you have a lot of people that's, you know, they actually getting behind this whole movement to not support the NFL. You know, to actually stand with him because until a team signed out. The Baltimore Ravens, they didn't gain interest. But what you say, Smokey D, they didn't took like a voting or a polling or what you say happened?
Well, basically, you know, the owner is looking for the fans to support. And he really don't want any backlash with signing him and everything like that. That's basically what's going on. He don't want to be crucified for giving this man a chance.
Now, I have a problem with that. You are in complete and total control of your organization. You get what I'm saying? These people coming to your establishment to see your team and everything else, you know. So I think you do have complete control over how this whole thing can be addressed and how it can be controlled in your environment and when it goes, you know. Now, it's up to the NFL to put notice out to other teams and everything, to their stadiums, to their fan cities and everything else when he come in, to respect him because he's coming to represent your company. Now, what he does outside of his personal life is his business.
Right. I mean, if you're Ravens fans and he's going to win games for you, what the hell do you care about what's going on? And he didn't commit a crime.
Because he's still quality. I don't know what's wrong with, I don't know what's wrong with these teams, and y'all need a quarterback. You know, he's still quality. What he does in his personal life is his own personal business, because I'm quite sure a lot of you owners do have a very racist fucking outside culture up about yourself. Let's just keep it real. I'm gonna just go all out and just say that. I'm quite sure y'all go and support certain KKK groups and everything else.
Damn, man.
So I'm just keeping it real.
So you saying that they funding these KKK?
I wouldn't put it past them. I wouldn't put it past them.
My thought is they don't give a fuck about what you're doing or whatever, as long as they brand or something.
Time for somebody say that. Something about that shit, man.
You know,
this man is taking the stands for me. So yeah, it's quite personal when you get people like fucking Ray Lewis. That use his platform to show his real true colors, man.
Damn, man, you just kind of leapfrog, man. We
man, I'm sorry, man, because my blood got a little bit boiling, man. The mad listener's in me a little bit today.
I mean, I get that. And one thing was brought about the owners, though, and we know the history that it's not a black owner, and they've been shutting that out for the longest time. And then, you know, you're using your horses or your stallions, and that's basically the black athletes. Not to say it's not any other nationality in the NFL. And then when they go on, they just use it, something like that. We all know the history about when they're getting these concussions and everything, and they had to do a lawsuit to get money and take care of these former players and everything after these owners get rich. So they
give a damn. It's time for the NFL, the actual NFL, the presidents and everything else. It's time for them to step in and say something.
Players union has to step in.
That
and start,
too. That
start
too.
Saying so.
Because they had, because he's out there dangling by himself. And Baltimore basically exposed what every team concern is. The image of the team and how the fans are going to react and everything else. That's the major. It's not that he can't play. It's what he represents.
And that gets
let's just get that 100% crystal clear. With some Windex and wipe it down real good. It's what he represents. And that's the fucking problem. Ray Lewis.
So you mean to tell me you get people out there killing, raping, Ben Roethlisberger, doing all these.
Yeah, man, I like Big Ben. Don't do that.
But
I know, I understand.
He committed a crime.
I understand. I'll just let you go here.
And I know Raven fans ain't still a fans, but, you know.
I like Big Ben as a player, his game. I don't know nothing about his personality. Let's get that clip. So go ahead.
But that's the token. You Raven fans can't, you know, stand behind somebody because they can play and the talent they have instead of what you think that type of person he is. And he's not even a bad person. He's not committing crimes. He's standing up against an injustice in this country that has been addressed over centuries.
He's not taking a stand against the NFL. No, he's not taking a stand against the NFL. He wants to play. That's the fucked up part about it. He wants to play. and probably will play for a little bit of nothing. So you motherfuckers might get a bargain deal.
But they don't look at that.
You might get a dollar store deal.
Their brains are so naive, so shrunken down, that they don't look at the fact that, yeah, you might have somebody who can win you a couple games or get you into the playoffs. No, you're talking about Old Glory and everything like that. Oh, he disrespected this.
You motherfuckers, let me tell you something. Y'all got a problem with what he doing, and to some of you white people that out there, because I done seen some of y'all say some real, like, cruel stuff. America don't even really truly stand behind y'all ass.
And my question to them is this.
So think about it. He might be standing up for something about y'all rights, too, that's in the Constitution that motherfuckers don't know about. So that's something for y'all to think about, you know, in the long run, to be put in deep thought, to have a real true meaning to what he really standing for. Yeah, black folks are the forefront in the way we've been treated, the way we've been treated, and we have been treated for a long fucking time. Sorry for cussing so much. Vulgar content, but this pissed me off. And this motherfucker Ray Lewis, I'm waiting, I'm ready to talk about him, but yeah, I'm gonna keep mentioning your name, motherfucker.
Well, we gonna get to that. Well, man, I only got one thing to add though.
You and Mike Vick have really fucking pissed me off, man. I'm gonna just let
like
y'all
I said, we got time for them. We going in on them, definitely, you know.
Well, I think we might need to take a break, man, and come back and come in and talk.
But Hippie, I got one question for you though. One question. With all these Baltimore Raven fans or residents having an uproar about possible signing of Colin Kaepernick, why y'all didn't say nothing about the boy getting killed by the police? Y'all turned y'all head on that, but they ain't nothing to do with y'all, right? But you get mad at somebody who stands up for that and is really speaking out and using a platform to do so. So what's the problem here? I mean, hey, we're really pointing you out. I mean, we're really coming at you. And I wish I had known some people in Baltimore so I could throw this out there, too.
It's motherfuckers writing checks. That's what it is. As long as a motherfucker writing a check and they cashing it and they family all right and all that other stuff and they drive them pretty fancy cars and wear them nice suits, we going to continue getting this. Write your own check, motherfucker. You got enough money. Fuck you. Oh, these motherfuckers getting on my nerves, man. I swear they are. Go ahead, man. Keep talking, man.
And my whole thing still is, too. Nobody said nothing about
man gave $1 million of his own fucking money, man. Can't believe you motherfuckers, man. Go ahead.
And they still painting him out to be the devil or something like that. Just because he kneeled.
Gave away his goddamn wardrobe to people who he knew didn't have the money to go out there and get jobs and everything else. That's one way to boost the economy. Ray Lewis, I understand, yeah, you put it out. You ready to talk about this motherfucker, man?
We might as well, because it's already put out there.
Let's go ahead and get into the song, man. Let me wipe my mouth off.
Go ahead and strike.
I'm ready to bite the shit out. I'm ready to bite his nose off, man. Like, for real, you and Mike Vick didn't really piss me off, man. We're going to get to Smoke Music, man. Tribe Called Quest. Maybe I'll be in a better vibe when we come back. Live at the Blaq Show down here in the Playa Cave. Y'all catch it on the Blaq Hippie Radio Entertainment website every day, all day, and any day. You dig? Smokey D.
Always, always,
we
everywhere.
Playing. We plug. Let's go.
It's going to be like air. Check it out.
On the boulevard, I landed. We used to kick routines and the presence was fitting. It was I, the abstract.
And me, the five-footer. I kicks the mad style, so step off the Frankfurter.
Yo, Fife, you remember that routine that we used to make spiffy like Mr. Clean?
A tidbit, a spidgin. I don't get the message, so you got to
okay.
Run the pigeon.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
So then grab the microphone and let your words rip.
Now here's a funky introduction of how nice I am. Tell your mother, tell your father, send a telegram. I'm like an energizer, cause you see I last long. My crew is never ever whack because we stand strong. Now if you say my style is whack, I swear you're dead wrong. I say that body and El Segundo, then push it along.